Good afternoon. It continues. We have company.
Yo-ho!
This is Joep, and Joep wants a mixing console, so that's why we start with a mixing console. Normally Mondays, it's Monday today, are my walking days with Joep. We walk every Monday, but the weather is horrid, so we're doing this instead. There you go. And I couldn't just tell him to sit and wait until next Monday, obviously. This is an Inkle mixing console, the MX642. Which looks remarkably good. I don't think it's that old. I have no idea how it sounds or who built it, because I don't think Inkle built this themselves. We're about to find out.
It be working!
It be working! It be working.
I hear the trains are coming, it's rolling round the bend.
Yeah.
And I have seen no sunshine since I fucking don't know when. I bet you rich folks eating and drinking coffee. And smoking big cigars. I know I had it coming. I know I can be free. Is this mixer working properly?
Then yes,
it belongs to me.
This one has a bit of a cult status. Yes, it's a vertical record player. Yes, it can play both sides of the record. Yes, it has a door. I completely forgot how to turn this thing on. I used to own one. Here it is, okay. And these tend to work all right, actually. Let's see if this is an exception to that rule or not so much. And we're running. Told ya. Not hearing anything, though. There we are. Okay, shite music. Where are my testing tapes? Wake up, Sharp. You can do this. We got one channel so far. Let's try the radio. Let's see if we can get some noise going. Okay, nothing yet. Okay, let's get a record then. Let's see if we can fix that radio later, because of course this is the pièce de la résistance, if it works, which I think it's not. Okay, we're gonna have to open this one up and replace some belts, because obviously there's a motor spinning, but nothing opening, which is a pity, because this would be cool to demonstrate. But yeah, all we got is tape so far, which now also stopped working. This needs a bit of love, but I feel like this is going to be just fine. Trying to figure out which switch is the problematic one. There's one switch, probably messing with them all. And I think it's the phono one. There you go. There you go. Let's get an antenna. Radio! Pretty sure music rights are not going to be an issue with that, so now that we have a source, let's see if the thing records, because it may as well. Ooh, stereo and noise! Okay, that's enough. Sounds like it needs a bit of a clean. That capstan is incredibly gross. We've got some slippage going on, but at least all functions are working. Computer tape. Realistic from the Dandy Corporation. Audio 901. I'm still surprised that such a typically American brand made it to the Netherlands. This is definitely not. I think someone homebrewed this. That's interesting. I fully expect this one to be broken. It's a BSR record player, and we all know what BSR stands for. Bloody strong rumble. Yeah, the mechanism is stuck, as they tend to. And sometimes you can actually help them and they figure that stuff out again, but I'm not sure if that's going to work with this one. Because it feels extremely stuck. And of course you can open it up and... please don't do that. And, oh, 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 oh. We have something. I actually don't want to use the automatic right now. Just start. Okay. It's a diesel. Are you kidding me? It does solve our music rights issue. I'm just wondering what it's doing. I think it's just the vibrations of the motor actually just making the arm jump around. Yeah. Something is rubbing. Oh, that solved itself. It sounds pretty horrible, to be honest. Is this bass and this is treble? Yeah. I'm gonna give this one a chance because that is way more functionality than I had expected. So, if the only thing that's broken is the auto start, I would say it's worth fixing the auto start. In the these are always broken category, this Dual, what's the model number? HS50, it's a Dual 1209 with a built-in amplifier. These rarely work properly. But we got lucky before. Well, it's not doing anything so far, to be honest. Someone made a switch there. That's definitely not original. But if it works, it's not a stupid idea. The automatic system appears to be. Oh, we got bad noises. Yeah, that needs an overhaul. But okay, it's doing all sorts of things. I didn't ask it to do anything. Can you please stop? Does it come with the... Yeah, it does actually. Good. I want to take this out. It's a bit annoying right now. Here we are. And put in the original one that is actually still there, surprisingly. And not the original adapter. That's a Philips. We got a lot of transistor noise, so this one... Oh, it's not transistor noise, it's dirt. Good. Maybe. Not sure. Stereo mono switch. Let's see what we get. Stylus looks a bit old, but do we get any sound? I don't think so. They built in a weird system with a relay. That is not original. Oh, whoa! Fuck logic, okay. That doesn't sound healthy, but other than that... Yeah, that's got no tip. I think if I remember correctly, yep, there's another Shure stylus. I remember putting that there. So that's an easy fix. There you go! Wilson! SL600, it's another Tandy. It's another BSR as well, expecting this one to be equally iffy, although the previous one was a bit of a surprise. I always fight these changers. I don't know how people live with them, or how they do them, but I always fight them. Whatever, I'm just going to put the record underneath it. Yeah, same story, 33, 45, 78. It's actually pretty much the same mechanism. Stylus is just dangling there, so I'm not expecting too much of that. Let's see if we get anything. It is on. It is running. And I didn't plug in any speakers. So, other than that, not much is going to happen until I do. What is going on, people? Why is this going so well? Oh, same story. Automatic system. This one's slightly better than the previous one. It's just managing. Oh, that was not exactly as intended. Yeah, oh, whoa, 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 whoa. That was very dramatic, but it was actually correct because 7-inch. Let's try this again. Auto. 12-inch. Gonna give it a little bit of help this time. Ooh. Yeah, hardened grease is an issue, but... Ooh. How? I'm not sure how it's supposed to work, but that's definitely not how. Sounds alright otherwise. I'm actually pleasantly surprised. Easter is coming. Another unlikely hero. Will it blend? That's the question. And honestly, I don't know what to say anymore. This one should not work. But will it? That is not good. That is really not good. Cool. So, This all makes sense. This one is broken. Record player works. Well, that's actually a pity, because that seems to work. Actually. Oh, nein, Steuerpimpel! Die Steuerpimpel ist kaputt! That's something they do. They have a little plastic pin that breaks. It's easy to replace. It's a little plastic pin on a metal pin, so you can just shove anything over it. Usually I just grab a little bit of cheap wire, cheap electricity cable, whatever, and I just shove it over. But this has an amplifier issue. That's definitely sort of DC coming through the speakers. And die Steuerpimpel ist kaputt! Also, this ain't working. Finally, something that's logically broken. It's a Sony PSLX320. I really like those. And this is a bit of an upmarket one with the little light, which is working. Let me get another record now, because the guys of CCR must be getting angry with me playing their music without paying them. Some of them are dead, I think. Doesn't matter. Start. Oh, no! But then, it is a belt drive. So, first of all, I should make sure the mat is there, because there's actually sensors there that know where the record is, so I need to fix that. The belt is also there, so why are you not spinning? Let me... Oh, I can see what's going on here. Yeah. So, as these players tend to do, the automatic return mechanism broke. And they actually removed the cog that's attached to the spindle that is supposed... Oh no, but it's here. Oh, then I don't know why it's not working. Maybe it's fixed now. Let's see. Oh, that's what you get. I'm skeptical. So far so good. Yay. Drop it. Seems very quiet. Oh, I turned this down. I don't know what kind of cheap remake stylus this is, but that's not how that cartridge is supposed to sound. Auto return. Yeah, that's about as defective as these get. It didn't start first try, and now it's fine. Very underrated record players. Nice landing. Yep, well, this was a safe bet to begin with. It's also a pretty good looking one. Needs a little polish. Should be good. Nothing major. But the stylus is incredibly low quality remake, so I'm going to replace that, and then this should be good to go. Joep in all his handsomeness is very, very distracting. He bent back to build. Where is the man? Aha! So I forgot to make a video of this one. It's an IMG Stageline DJP100. It's a piece of junk, but it runs rather well. Quick start. Neil Young has removed his music everywhere, so I guess I should respect that. So the arm bearing on these ones is always incredibly loose, and that may seem like a defect, but the quality control on these machines is so low that if you tighten it, chances that it won't move smoothly are pretty high. So you could get a good one and actually tighten it would be fine. I had a sound lab recently with the same idea that I tightened and it was perfectly okay. And sometimes you tighten them to get rid of the play and they just refuse to track. So I'm going to try that and see if this is a good or a bad one. But it is as intended and it works fine otherwise. Nothing wrong with this IMG stage line. Also, this is the Sanyo MG09D cartridge. I made a video recently on a cartridge called the... what was it called again? Mustang. And I compared it to the Numark Groove Tool. The Mustang was $299, the Groove Tool is $19.95. The Groove Tool and the Mustang are based on this $9-ish Sanyo cartridge. And it's nothing special, but it does the job. You can hear it's an harmonica, so it's good in my book. I did the thing, not too shabby. That's a whole lot less play. It's like hearable, but you don't even see it move anymore. So this, for this kind of record player, it's extremely acceptable. It continues. If you hear some music in the background very quietly, it has to be quiet because of music rights. I'm recording a tape for the buyer, hopefully buyer of my car. I've been having a really nice chat with him, and which is still open in the background. And it turns out he's going to play cassettes in it once he finds a suitable cassette radio. It's a 1998 Peugeot 205. There's a video of it on my channel. And yeah, he's going to play cassettes in it. So I figured, since he's a very nice guy so far, I would... okay. I would make him a cassette. Anyway, we got something super unique here. It may look like a simple Akai record player. It may look like a simple APB-100, but it's not. It's the APB-10 with a straight arm. Never saw that in my life. That's an interesting clip. That works well, actually. So yeah, it looks really good. The APB-10s usually work absolutely fine. This one has a... Sorry, the 100 works fine. This one has a bit of a meh belt. But let's see if it it should still play with that belt. Let's see if it does. Oh wow, it's not automatic. Normally it has a start-stop knob here. This is just power on-off. 33, 45. I fully expect this to work flawlessly, to be honest. Let's see. Yep. Yep, nothing wrong with that. Oh, I like this. That button is pretty heavy, but it's a nice record player. Does it? So it says manual turntable. So it has no auto stop or return. I'm a bit of a fan of this one. It's good. I like it. Yeah, there we are. It's a mini disc with a knob. That is not original. That's said, if it works. Doesn't seem to do much. Helps if I plug it in. How do I still manage to not think of that? Badly recorded. One side. What the hell? How loud is that disc recorder? Anyway, eject button is a bit iffy. Fuji Minidisc. That was very loud. Sorry, neighbor. Oh my god! How did they make pitch control on this like that? What? That's pretty genius. So they built pitch control on this Minidisc. That is not original. I think this is a knob from a Marantz, actually. This button is not quite happy, but yeah, it works. And we're recording. Oh, it's on mono. I can't switch now. Let's start again. Here we go. The remaining time was very long all of a sudden. I wonder what happens if you... Something's not gonna work on record. That's ingenious though. How did they do that? Yeah. Oh my. How did they do that? Let's record and see if it actually works in the opposite direction. So now I'm saying it faster. Will it play back slower? Or will it also play back faster? Curious. It plays back slower. I have absolutely no idea how they did that, but that is... What? It's an Akai AP100C, and these tend to have the issue that they don't stop. It's a spark killer that is there, and then they just don't stop. This one so far does not start, but then I don't know if the belt is on there. Also, I'm not sure if I... plugged in the power. Yeah, it's spinning. Okay, let's put this belt back. Doesn't want to go to 45, but that's just... Yeah, the mechanism works. So that's just the belt. That's not a biggie. Super heavy mat. These have those. Always a bit impressed with that. I'm not saying it's such a great thing, but it feels like they didn't want to make it cheap. Let's get ourselves a record. Okay. Weight all the way forward. Let's not do that. That's maybe not enough. Looks like a Nagaoka JT511 or 311 or so. Which is alright, it's nothing special, but... Okay, lift down, doesn't do anything, so that means I have to do this. It's a bit of a weird one to work with, this. There you go. I hear... Okay, it's not getting its speed quite right. Bit weirded out by that. The belt really doesn't seem that bad. Why is it behaving so weirdly? Ah, because it actually is bad. Okay, so the belt really needs replacing, as far as I can tell. That's all. I usually don't get DVD players, but this one's kind of interesting because it's got a 69 kHz 24-bit converter. It's multi-system, so PAL and NTSC, and it just looks like a pretty serious device. So, oh god, those again. And the thing is, if it's a Sony, it always fixes itself. Not with this one. Okay, I'm just gonna test this one for the heck of it. Let's be quick. There you go. It'd be playing. Yep. Yeah, that's a pretty good sounding DVD player, but it has the obvious issue. Another DVD player, same story, kind of upmarket, kind of fancy. I'm a bit intrigued because actually the S-Video out, that's not that rare. The other one at RGB out, that's kind of nice. But this one has a center front surround and mixed out. And I'm not sure if mixed means stereo or an absolute mess. What did they just say? Bye, it says, okay, off. Welcome to DVD world. Oh boy. No, it's the Marantz DVD 3000 and it's annoyingly slow. At least it stays open. Looks really beautiful though, it's in really good shape, this one. No disc. Uh-oh. Oh, gotta be quick, it's trying to read. There's a disc in there. What's on it? Yeah, that's not a very good... Nothing against Ravel or Bizet, but no. It was a disc of Ravel and Bizet. Works though! Seriously, we loaded so much audio into this house that there's even things that I don't remember seeing before, like this Tia cassette deck. Let's see what it does. No, it just runs. Oh, I did that. I'm not sure why side B of this tape is empty. I'm sure I recorded it, but somehow something went wrong. I will need to re-record that. It sounds fine though in this direction. Does it sound fine in reverse? Yeah, that's all right. Turn the low down a bit. Low end the lows down a bit because neighbors. Ooh, one touch recording in reverse, cool. But I actually want record pause. There we go. Six whole segments. And here we go. Kind of a cool machine. It's simple, but it's pleasing. Not too many segments again, but you don't really need them, do you? As expected. Yeah, balance. That's just spot on. Yeah, but it's another one of these. I'm not sure if it's exactly the same one as the previous one. It may be. What am I doing wrong here? Speakers. Yep. I mean, it's a JVC. Of course it works. Yeah, and then let's go to VCR. No noise. So yeah, that's the phono preamp noise. Pretty quiet. This is a heavy machine. I'm not sure if it's exactly the same as the previous one. This is an RX 506V, but it's got a pretty sizable power supply. And yeah, nice and discreet. Not sure how many watts this is, but it comes over quite heavy. Okay, 210 watts, so reasonably you can't expect more than 60 times 2, but 210 watts power consumption. But it sounds all right. This is actually a really good series of amplifiers. Just have to sort of accept the fact that it works with micro switches and with knobs, which I personally think is a bit annoying because it's a bit slow. But it does work flawlessly with these amplifiers and quietly, because sometimes you hear them go tick 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 between volume changes, which I think is a bit cheap. And it never scratches or anything. They always work quietly. So yeah, looks good to me. Jefferson. These don't ace gracefully, but they are actually worth an overhaul because these are pretty damn good amplifiers. This one is missing some knobs, so I'm gonna have to find some knobs that look good on it. I think I'm just gonna maybe, I don't know. I don't know which one I'm going to swap, but it's going to need some knobs. I'm probably not going to find the right ones, but does it work? Tone control off, bass somewhere in the middle, I guess. Everything is neutral, which is on aux, and let's see. I pause the music. Oh, there you go. Okay. You know what? Phono? Yeah, definitely. Bit of crosstalk between the switches, but this works beautifully. Thing with these videos is I have absolutely no idea how long they're gonna be, so I'm not gonna say goodbye, see you in the next video, because I may just chop one day into two or whatever. So in case this is the end of the video, goodbye. Maybe I'll be done with editing for this one. I have no idea. Thing is though, if the Samsung from the previous video, I assumed the previous video because I did say goodbye somewhere, is anything to go by. Eh, this doesn't work. There we are. Then this, oh, that didn't work. Then this Samsung should also be incredibly reliable. It's a pretty nice record player. It somehow reminds me of the Pioneer CT990? PLMI90. Yeah, I'm wrong. It's definitely not the same, but you can see, speed adjust, speed control, reject, strobo. But it's not the same. It's got a completely different arm and everything. I like the way this looks. I like that it has a pretty solid cable. It has unbelt, it has a T4P cartridge. This is an Audio-Technica 1892 by the looks of things. We are spinning. I hope it doesn't have a built-in preamp, because it is of that age that it could. It doesn't, because I don't get a lot of noise. But as you saw just now, the ground fell out, so let's try and clamp this in here. Okay, the speed needs adjusting. They are not... if 33 is correct, 45 isn't. There is a slight buzz. That's probably just this, but it's... reject. Yeah. It's picking up some signal somewhere, but nothing major. And auto return. Yep, that works. I haven't tried the lift yet, I think. Let me do that. Bit fast, not overly. It's all right. I'm putting you guys a bit higher because this you have to see. So I saw this simple plasticky sharp stereo system. I said, well, what are we gonna do with that? Has no platter. Then I looked at it, I was like, wait, linear tracker on a simple system. Then I felt, and I was like, that's heavy, extremely heavy. Also, direct drive, there's no belt there, right? And then I saw this little text that says Sharp VZ1500, both sides play disc stereo system. The arm can go all the way around and play the other side. Thing is though, this is probably not gonna work. If it works, we are in for a treat. Play. That's not good, is it? Okay, it's trying to pull back now. Oh, here we go. It's moving. Oh, wow, that was sudden. Okay. Weird sounds are happening. I think this arm motor system needs a new belt. Or I hope it's a belt. Definitely running slow. I'm pretty sure the speed is going to be adjustable, so that's going to be fine. But I'm helping the system because it's not moving on its own. But if I help it, it works. Sounds all right. So what if I put it at the end and help it, and I'm going to set it to play both sides, and I'm going to put it down, gets to the end of the record, right? If I help it at least. Now, is it going to figure out that it needs to go, okay, maybe lift it. Okay, I'm just going to, yeah. Okay, so it's turning the record the other way already. Yeah. Okay, it's going without help a bit, but it needs help, obviously. Now it's going to be tricky because at some point... oh my god, the coolness factor is off the scale. And we are playing side B of the record. This is just... That's actually side A. I've messed that up, but... Can you do this? No, you can't. Okay. It definitely needs love, but I'm not sure if I want to get rid of this thing. Because that is one of the coolest things I've seen in a very long time. Let me try if the cassette works, actually. Sharp tends to be pretty reliable. And this is probably just a bad belt. And some greasing. It is moving on its own now, but I don't think it's supposed to go this slow. It did improve. Let's go to tape. We have fast forward. We have rewind. We have no play. Oh, we also don't have fast forward anymore. And nothing else. That's gonna be fixable. But for now, it's stuck. So, probably gonna be fine. Radio then, I guess. No antenna. Yeah, it works though. Radio works, but obviously the pièce de la résistance is this awesome record player. What the hell? That's so cool. Noodles break and tea, but I'm gonna do the tea while I work. We're actually getting somewhere. We're done with most of the audio. I think there's like 10 or so left, maybe 12. But there's still loads of speakers. I'm gonna do some speakers now. I'm gonna work for another hour, then it's 1 o'clock at night. And then I'm gonna call it quits for today, but let's see how far we get. So, T, and dual loudspeakers, and I think one's upside down, but I'm not sure which one. It must be this one then. Yes. They have female DIN plugs at the back, which is interesting because those usually go on the amplifier side of things. And yes, you can rotate the logos because often people put them sideways in their bookcase. Anyway, let's see if they work. Yeah, and this is always a thing with these duals. Broken. How are they both upside down now? The tweeters are there. Doesn't matter. Broken tweeters are a thing. Let's see. No, those are properly broken. I can't wake them up. I don't know why, but these always seem to be broken. It's odd. So the friend who brought all this audio here keeps saying these are JBL controls, but nothing about them tells me that these are JBL controls. A nice soft dome. No place to put a JBL logo. JBL always does that. So I'm not so sure, but let's see how they sound. That's what it's all about. Ooh. Oh, that's more than just a little bit good. Very defined. Slightly sharp in the middle, like typical PA mid-range. That's a bit of a problem. I should fix that because there will be some leakage there, but yeah, other than that, these are actually really awesome. I'm gonna Google them and see if I can find anything that resembles them. I don't think these are controls at all. What are these? What is this? Industrielle Steuerungs- und Installationstechnik. Also. Yep, that's them, but that's the company that, as far as I can tell, installed them. I have absolutely no clue what these are, but they sound awesome, so. Yeah, let me adjust you a little, because the angle's getting a bit weird, isn't it? Man, these are rough. I don't think you can see very well in the video, but they're extremely dirty. I think cats have been in this. I love cats, but they have not been very kind to these speakers. The bottoms have holes in them. And the brand is Gracia Tech Power 175. These are in good shape, actually. Don't feel like they're gonna go anytime soon. That may actually be a fake tweeter. I have no idea what to expect. Okay, maybe some low end. Oh, that's really bad, actually. Not a lot is coming out of that. As far as I can tell, those are fake. And that one's obviously broken. But since it's not that easy to destroy a woofer, I'm going to quickly screw it out of the cabinet. And we're gonna do two things. First of all, see if it's even hooked up. Second of all, laugh at how tiny the magnet is and how cheap the metal is, because these are obviously extremely bad speakers. Actually, there's some weight to it. Okay. On the Gracia Tech. Now, I know Gracia is actually a brand that is somewhat serious, but this is Gracia Tech. It's not the same. This is completely unfiltered to begin with. Yeah, okay. So apparently this is completely dead. It could have been cheaper, if I'm honest. It could have been worse, but this woofer is apparently dead because there's no filtering or anything. It's not like the filter can be broken or... Nope, or any of the circuitry of any. There's nothing in there. This woofer is just getting all of the signal. So most of the mid-range is probably coming from the woofer. And that's probably functioning as a tweeter. So I hope this is a full-range driver and not an actual mid-range. Otherwise, that would explain why the highs are so limited, because that, as far as I can tell, is a fake. What do we have behind this diffuser? Oh my god, it's a squawker. It's just mid-range. But to be honest, yeah, that is doing all the highs. No? I'm not sure. There is something coming out of there, maybe, but it's so little. I was not sure what... That's just looks. With some of the Yamo models, it actually made the tweeter sound nicer, which is not a good sign. But with these, it's just looks. It doesn't do anything. It just makes it lose its definition. Just made to look like cool 80s Yamo speakers. These are, yeah. Akai made quite a lot of very decent equipment, but their speakers definitely were not their strongest point. Oh boy. Ah. Definitely messed up the phase there. There we go. Oh boy. There's not many redeeming qualities. The mids are incredibly cheap sounding. The highs are... Well, they have highs, but the lows are... Hollow. It's not great. They're cute. There's no brand on these, but I think they are supposed to go with that Tandy record player, the second one we did with the sort of rounded fronts. I like the design, I expect them to sound, yeah, like that. If you turn up the highs, there's some highs. Not a lot. Oh boy. Yeah, these are not great, but I do love the design. It's something. It's interesting how the guy who owned all that audio was an elderly gentleman. An elderly gentleman. He actually had quite a lot of pretty okay stuff. Also a lot of crap, but a lot of pretty okay stuff. But his speakers are all way, way subpar. These were not part of that deal. These are very early Bang & Olufsen Beovoxes. They are pretty big, which is why you only see one right now. And these are the early model with the very interesting layout. So not the Cees tweeter and woofer, but some... Yeah, something that you sort of expect to sound horrible. As far as I know, though, they don't. But then I haven't heard these yet. Maybe they're broken. We are about to find out. And the song is over. Very high efficient, because I hear loads of hiss from the amplifier. tennis speaker with a super rigid, cheap cardboard woofer that barely moves, and the way too large cone tweeter have so much transparency, so much refinement, and so much detail, and such a lovely, lovely loose low end. Look at the thing. This sound, even at this level, they sound amazing. These are, the old Bang & Olufsen's are among the most underrated speakers out there. These, but also the slightly later ones with the C's, tweeter and woofer. These are such good speakers. They are so much better than anything that Bang & Olufsen did later. Yet these fetch virtually nothing. $100? 150? I have absolutely no reason to keep them, but these are beautiful sounding speakers. Like, really good. Extremely good. If you have a tube amplifier, something that doesn't produce a lot of power, this is exactly what you need. These smell like an old pub. Probably because they were used by an old pub. I think they're homebrew. They're not that nicely finished, but they seem very well built. Let's see what these are going to do, if they work and if they sound any good. They don't. They sound horrible, but that's also because I got the phase wrong on one. I think I got the phase wrong on the one of my plugs. There we go. Everything seems to work, but that one definitely has more highs. Those toms are actually really good. They're really realistic sounding. The rest though, it's all a bit hollow. The highs are a bit muffled. I feel like, fuck. I feel like these are not gonna open. I feel like these are pretty good speaker units. Maybe except for the highs, in pretty mediocre cabinets. And I know I shouldn't do this because they're never gonna close properly again, are they? This is the kind of stuff that you take apart, that you build once and then never take apart. They're a bit rusty, by the way. I can imagine that they would sound better after some exercise. Before I open them up, I'm gonna see if I can even get these two. Ooh, this one, already someone tried and they ruined it. Oh no, this screw is ruined, so I'm gonna do that some other time. They're well built, but just not the right size for the woofer. I'm pretty sure these are not gonna come off. Oh, okay. That glue is dry. I don't really know how these are built, but that's not gonna come off. So, yeah, they're not awesome. I'm gonna have to be honest. I forgot about these. These are junk speakers, but thing is, if they work, there should be sound going to the amplifier right now. Are these completely broken somehow? Are these just completely dead? That would be odd. I'm not gonna change anything, I'm just gonna plug this one in instead of the other one. Completely dead. This man really liked collecting stuff with DIN connectors, didn't he? Here's a pair of Schneider speakers, which I somehow did not expect to have DIN, but then I think it's German, so, or at least sold in European German-speaking market. So it makes sense that it has DIN, but they look so, you know, 80s Japanese, that somehow I didn't expect them to have DIN going on, but it doesn't matter. They are also pretty junky, but then they look, you know, neutral, so if you have a simple stereo, they're not gonna mismatch looks-wise, which is worth something. Let's see how they sound. Oh, it's full range. They sound horrible, actually. There's no highs. Literally none. It's just mids and boomy low end, and they're in horrible shape anyway. Look at that. So yeah, there's actually, I think it's supposed to be this way up, but doesn't matter, they're horrible. the last pair of speakers. I don't know the brand yet, but I could carry them together. The brand is... Oh. There ain't any. Looks like the same kind of stuff as those first ones. There's literally nothing on these. Same on this? Yeah, same on that one. These are definitely not homebrew, but they have no brand. The surrounds are good. This is probably not one of those fake tweeters, although the previous one probably was real. Let's see. Yeah, same story, there's virtually no highs. This is definitely working though. Yeah, it's all working, but... Ladies and gentlemen, let the countdown begin. 5 record players to go. And this one has a very short power lead. What the hell? I hate when people do that. Try and get that sticky mess off, and also it ruins your veneer more often than not. Oh, that's not a good sign. I just realized it also has tape at the back. Tapes on as a whole. So no, don't do this, people. No staples, please. No hinges. That's fine. It does come with a manual, which I think is way cooler than hinges. It's an Eagle B7500. Some OEM. I expect this to be one of the CEC Japanese OEMs. It actually does come with the anti-skating weight, which is pretty rare. Automatic stop is not doing its thing. Oh, that's not doing anything. It's just... Whee! Let's use this return. That does work. It doesn't turn the system off, though. Oh, well. This was once a belt. We are slightly too late. This is now a gooey mess. I was hoping I would get through this part today. Because how long can record players take? But this... It's gonna set us back a bit. You may think to yourself, but it's so much fun. Why do you wanna go get through that pile today? Because my house is an absolute mess. Living room has all the speakers, there's a big pile there. Still looks pretty okay here, a bit messy, but okay. My utility room is completely full. I don't have to do laundry now, I planned this. But if I had to do laundry, I had a problem. Guest room, still a mess, although most of it is out there now. Hallway has all the stuff that doesn't work. It's chaos, I want my house back. But, yeah, this is a thing. It also all smells very bad, by the way. My house now smells of mildew and nicotine. So it's definitely not the best thing for your health, all this. My hands are also all red and irritated from the cleaning products. Do I love doing this, though? Oh, yeah, yeah. I love every second of it. It's just that at some point you're happy to be done for a bit. And also, this is going to be a hell of a lot of video editing. Okay, we have not really a stylus, something there, but it's completely bent, definitely not usable anymore. Some OEM phono cartridge, but I think it is clean enough to at least try if it works. No big chunks of belt on here, no, it fell down before it could do that. So I'm not gonna bother to try and find the perfect belt, I just wanna see if it runs. This belt actually isn't that far off, it may be a bit tight. Don't use too tight belts, by the way, people. It will ruin your record player's motor bearings, and that is a shit job to repair if you can repair it at all. This one's too tight, so I'm gonna take it off after I'm done testing. Anyway. I don't think... Why are we not getting anything? Is the cue not far away? Oh, the lift is not down far enough. Wait, let me push this down and see. Okay, there's two things. First of all, there's a buzz, and I don't see any ground cable. Ah! Okay, it has one of those ones that actually you have to separately attach, which is a bit annoying, but we've got plenty of cables laying around here. Here's some speaker cable, let's use that. And then let's find out which one to connect. Hey, it's not USB, so I got it right in one go. And then the camera said beep beep, and my SD card was full. I don't know how many hours that was, but that was a 64 gig SD card in 25 frames per second, 2.7K resolution. This is a slower card. It actually tells me SD card's slow, so gotta be careful with that. Oh yeah, that wasn't working. Yep.
Ooh. I like this.
It's a Pioneer PL515, and I like this. Sorry, 514. And I like this because it has the good arm of the FAT series, so the better arm than the 512, for instance. But it's still no nonsense, no electronic speed control, belt drive, as I like them. It has auto return, which I don't think it needs, but whatever, it has that. And I forgot to hook it up to ground, so it's gonna buzz, but we're gonna fix that. There we are. Horrible cartridge, great record player. Blah! Way too much anti-skate. That's better. Oh, no auto return. Okay, that probably just needs adjusting. Although I have found out, there's actually an adjustment point here. I have found out that sometimes when you let it do it once, it will then figure its stuff out. It's in good shape, by the way. See if it figured it out now. I know my shit! I've lost count. I said there were 5 record players left, but I only see 4. So, 2 left now. Or did I just forget about the existence of one because I've seen so many? That's another Akai. It's an AP206C. That's a very upmarket model. I don't think they are particularly good. There's also the 306 and the 307, which is the fat one. I really don't think they are particularly good. As in, they usually work with not a lot of work. And that needs doing just some cleaning of pitch pots and sometimes removing a spark killer. But they are just not very musical sounding. They sound dead as a dodo. Well, people like them though. They look pretty impressive. This one comes with an Audio-Technica 1895, the OG 1895, not the new version. Speed is way off, but that's because the pitch pots are dirty. This is just gonna work. Nice, smooth landing, speed though, again, way off. I got it correct now. Let's play Heart of Gold. I mean, I do love the cartridge. That sounds really lovely. Yeah, 45. In case people think I don't like Neil Young because of this beat up record, I adore Neil Young. I looked for a good copy of this one for 5 times before I found one. This is just one of the beat up ones. And yeah, I like using it as a test record because I love the music, but of course it's not being taken good care of. This was an eye opener for me, this record. It really changed my whole musical, the way I approached music when I was a kid. A friend of mine showed me this. I remember hearing those first tones, the typical muted the typical muted sound of the recording from his Lenko record player and his, I don't even know what speakers he had, just this. Immediately in love with the record. It's a gem, it's an absolute gem. This record player, though sounding boring as they do, and though having some particularly nasty dirty pitch pots that go all over the place. Usually it helps if you turn them a bit, but it does need a proper clean, so I'm going to open it up and clean them properly. But other than that, this is just... Oh, try and get the speed right of there. So if you... Come on, you can do this. Oh, that changes everything, doesn't it? There we are. Despite that, it's perfectly fine. This is a 20-minute fix, including cleaning. Last but not least... An Akai APB20C with a belt. Not a great belt, but it belts, I hope. It may actually not, it's in really bad shape. These also need power. These tend to work, but this belt may be bad enough for it to just spin. Yeah, power doesn't come from a cable. Power comes from... There you go! We are sinking. It's running slow because belt, but that's all. Okay, auto return. And then the question is, does it stop? Does. It does. Perfectly. It's very dirty, but... That's it for this series of videos, two or three. I'm not sure how much I'm going to make out of this. I hope you enjoyed it. And I actually got my, I'm not sure where I put it. I made this video with a headcam some time ago. And people liked the headcam idea. But of course it was a bit, you know, nauseating. So I got a chest strap for my GoPro. It's not a real GoPro. I may actually invest in that at some point. And I'm going to strap it to my chest pretty high. I'm going to see if that works. And see if it looks for, if it works for seeing how my hands move and how I'm working with stuff. I'm curious if that's going to be an interesting experiment. We will only know when the video is done, because I'm not going to stop halfway to check it. Next audio checking video that's coming up will have those shots. But for now, I'm happy I got through with this. And I'm going to sort of tidy up here so I can move again. Let me show you, actually. It's quite ridiculous. That's the pile of... it's a bit of a mess here, as you can see. There's the pile of speakers. So I'm going to tidy up a bit so I can sit here again and enjoy my tea. And then, I don't know, an apple or so. And then slowly go to bed, because it's 1:27. I said I would stop at 1, but you know how that goes. Have a good night, guys. Bye-bye.